Today, we are going to celebrate the puja of Virat and Viratangana. North America and South America, as you know, is the Sri Krishna's center of Vishuddhi. And it is very important to know also that all the communications, all the relationships with the whole creation has to be established through this center of Vishuddhi. Vishuddhi, as you know, is the most important center in your asset, in a way. Because Sahaja Yoga is not only meant for your ascent, but for the ascent of the whole world. And only through Vishuddhi you can achieve it. Even if you get your self-realization and you get all the powers, unless and until you use your Vishuddhi, it won't work out. Look at my Vishuddhi also. Talking everywhere, keeping communications, Vishuddhi goes out. Also, this Vishuddhi chakra being so important, it is under attack. Attack of the negative force. Today we are Virat and Viratangana. Virat is the ultimate, the complete development of the Vishuddhi chakra is Virat. And as you know, the chakra is here at this point. If this chakra is not all right, you are not correct. You behave in a manner that is not correct. You cannot communicate with other Sahaja Yogis. You cannot be friendly, loving, and one with other Sahaja Yogis. Unless and until this center here, Vishuddhi, is all right. And is part of the Ekadasha. Vishuddhi is the center of the Ekadasha Rudra. So, one has to understand that Virata Shakti is spread all over. We have communications, I could telephone from here to anyone, and they told me they don't charge much, it's something also from Sri Krishna's blessings, I think. God, you telephone from anywhere else is very difficult and very expensive. Also, most of the communications, vehicles like computer, like television, other things also, all those, so many of them, were developed in this country. So it is the subtle of that ether which communicates us to other worlds. That is one power of Virat. That he is the subtle of that. The second power which we have of Viratangana, we can say, because Virat is the kinetic force, but the source is Viratangana, is everything that brain can do. All thinking, all creativity, all compassion. all kinds of looking after other nations. The other day, somebody asked, why should we be policemen of the whole world? You jolly well have to. Because you are Viratas. So you have to look after the law and order of the whole world. You have to look after all the people who are suffering in this world. You have to look after all the separations and the wars and the civil wars everywhere. It's all your heading. Because you are sitting in the land of Virat. So he is the father, he is what you call Yehovah, he is Akbar. So on the brain level, when Kundalini reaches and enlightens your brain, then this science that you know becomes not only that, but you know meta-science. Because the brain, which was just knowing science, now knows the source of science. The whole thing it can see clearly. Like you climb up a hill or a mountain, the higher you go, you can see the whole vision of the place. In the same way, whatever is created out of your brain, anything, you start getting the whole vision of it, what they have created. Not only that, but you also see what has created that. Now they created United Nations. It had to be here, why? Why in America? Why America so much worried about United Nations? What is its responsibility? No country will do that. It's a headache. But they'll go to Vietnam, they'll go to Korea, now they are busy with Bosnia, everywhere. Somalia. Is your responsibility, because all these things are created by your brain. The human brain has created different nations. So above all, we realize that all these nations belong to one world. Once you rise above, you see that this was created by us. By our own thinking, by our own projections we have created. So when you go above this, you start thinking of one world, because you see that it was one world. It is one world. You start seeing God has universe and beautiful mountains. He never divided. I mean, he wanted to create beauty for you. But then we started thinking, this is my land, that is my land. Most of the Americans have come from outside. And the real landowners, I don't know where are they hiding. I seldom see them. Now the responsibility is coming in their heads that we have taken this land and we feel that this is our land. But it belongs to the whole world. Whatever they have done now is coming back. Once you rise higher, you start seeing the vision. Whatever you have done through your mental projections. People don't even realize in many countries that this is one world. Projection is on another level is that you have created a materialistic world. With this materialistic world, you have reduced everything to the level of money. Religion is money, everything is money. Nobody has any respect for anything but for money. And then material things. One starts seeing matter as a source of wealth and source of dignity and a source of great positions, powers. But when you rise higher into Virata's power, you see the stupidity of materialism. What is matter after all? Matter is for making the place beautiful, giving you joy, and this matter is also for expression of your joy to others. When you give them some present, some material thing beautifully made, then you start thinking also how God has created this beautiful world, and you start creating beautiful things in art, in music, drama, even films, everything. But at the material level and at the mental level, the projection is linear, it moves like this. As a result, it falls down. So everything, the standard of our expression has fallen down. I know films in the 20s and 30s and 40s from the same Hollywood were very different from what they are today. But you can't even see some of them. Then in the same mental projection, we see the dramas and the novels and the art. Everything has come down, is deteriorated, is not at all joy-giving. But it is destructive. It is destroying itself, first of all. And so it is destructive. As a result, we are moving our mind and moving on that decline also, and we also take to things which are destructive. Our standards in everything have gone down. Morality also is an innate blessing to human beings. But he starts putting it on a mental level. When you put it on the mental level, people like Freud become Christ. And you start following them and you become nothing but a sex boy. In every direction, if you see, there's a big decline. And you get upset. You don't understand how there is such a decline in human nature, how there's a decline in art, decline in literature, decline on human relationships. In everywhere you find this decline. With money, of course, certain things may appear to be smart, fast, like tennis, you can say. People used to play tennis for joy, never for money. But now they play for money and after 4 or 5 days, we find he's gone down, or 4 or 5 years is finished. So the speed has come into also sports because of money. This money has been like a big load, has brought down all the beautiful things in its own level. They are not the same level at which they are created. If it was on the same level, Sahaja Yoga would have worked very nicely in America. But it did not. Because here is the maximum load. on all our creations, of our mind, of our mental projections. Whatever direction you will see, you will find there is such a decline. We know of lawyers who would be so honest and would work out something for the person for whom they are fighting. But today you can bribe the lawyers. We know the doctors which would go all out to cure patients. They have lost their sense of ethics. Everybody has lost the sense of ethics. First is this materialism, money, and above all, I think, at this time, there's a big growth of people because this is a resurrection time. And many types of people are born. Thousands and thousands of them are born, who might be like animals or maybe some sort of absolutely idiotic type or maybe some stupid stuff. At this time, we have to do resurrection work. Means what? That our Virata Shakti has to be enlightened in our brain. So in Sahaja Yoga, when you rise into Virata Shakti, you go up and see all these declines, all these falling mental projections from that height. And also you see yourself that you had gone into all these nonsensical things. But now you feel that you have come out of it and now you have become like a lotus. Especially the ego part. Ego is extremely strong in modern times. It was never so. It is, I think, the birth of many fighting cocks has come on this earth. And also, some of the jungle creatures are also reborn. Because you can't talk to them. If they say anything, they just jump on. You cannot criticize them, you cannot tell them what's wrong with you. They'll just sit on your head. If you say anything, they'll start hitting. They never want to see what's wrong with you. It's impossible to communicate to them because of their ego. And this ego has come because of certain declining nature of the modern time. For example, from childhood, a mother starts scolding his child for spoiling a carpet. So carpet becomes more important. So the next day the child gets very angry. He gets the scissors and cuts the carpet to punish the mother. Then they see that the child wants money for something. Then they ask him for what? Because I have seen in the television that there is a bear which has a birth date. So a new type of devils have come up, they are entrepreneurs. And through their mental projections, they take out novel ideas. See, like a teddy bear which has a birth date. Can you imagine? Such a stupid idea. And all the children wanting to buy it. Now, if one child buys, another must have. All kinds of things these entrepreneurs do. And people start becoming slaves of them. Like in Paris, they started a fashion that you'll have 6 inches of skirts. So all other skirts were thrown away, the 6 inches skirt started. Imagine in that cold, they would wear socks and 6 inches of skirts. Everybody looks the same. What is so beautiful about it? Whatever they want, the entrepreneurs, so-called, they are called as artists, also as designers, But their designs are just to kill your freedom, just to make you a slave. And all kinds of monkey tricks they play, which you accept. Once you start accepting those monkey tricks, then you don't also realize that how you have become a slave. And there is no individuality about it. Hairstyle, they will start particular hairstyle. So everybody goes about with the same hairstyle. Or you go to a hairdresser, you go to the hairdresser and
बहुत जोर से आ जाती थी अदरवाइज इट स्टॉप्स व्हेन आई लुक एट इट बट अगेन थैंक यू वेरी मच
सो व्हेन यू राइट इनटू योर विराट शक्ति बाय द एनलाइटमेंट ऑफ द कुंडलिनी योर विराट अंगना इज द पावर विच गिव्स यू a complete vision of the decline into which every mental projection which was idealistic, beautiful, has fallen. For example, Abraham Lincoln gave a very great idealistic idea about a state. About democracy. But now many people say that is demonocracy. Those people who were in Russia, of course they were wrong, but still they had an argument that we don't want to become democratic. Because look at America. Nothing is safe, nothing is normal. So what's the use of becoming democratic country? Can you hear me? There. Yeah. It's all right, it's all right. After all, we are on a picnic, you see. And we cannot have any problems. Because I told him, whatever is here is here. And whatever is not here. So if you have any problem, we can't help it. So you rise to that level. Gradually, gradually, first, I don't know what you see, but you start seeing what's wrong with your society, what's wrong with your relationships. Ultimately you start seeing what's wrong with you, how you are wrong. That I would say is the higher state where you reach and you start seeing this is wrong with me. After that, you start understanding that you have got powers, Viratangana's powers. You have got powers. In your brain itself you have got powers. By which you understand the meta-science, science above science, the meta-art, the vulgarity of art, discrimination starts working. You start understanding what is really art, what is not. You start enjoying that art. and the enjoyment of Nirananda, you get it when you rise above and see the whole thing in a different perspective. First of all, you see it as a drama, as a witness. And you laugh, you see. I was telling a joke about a lady who was interviewed for doing some art with the mehndi on the hat. She's an Indian lady from India. So the interviewer asked her, but what about the foreigners? How do they react? The Americans, how do they react? She said that they ask very funny questions. Funny questions, yes. They asked me, what is this? So I said, this is my swag, my husband's symbol. That's why I wear. So they said, what about extras? You didn't follow. What about the extra husbands if you have? Now you all are laughing at it. You all Americans are laughing. But at that point you would not have laughed because very common. In the same way, everyone, even India or any place where they do absurd things, it becomes very obvious. And you start seeing it very clearly, very, very clearly, that what are we doing? It's all absurd. But this is not only on mental level, this is what I'm going to tell. It's not just you see the vision, all right, still mental level. Then you understand it is wrong, still mental level. But you just don't do it. You become part and parcel of Virat. When you become part and parcel of Virat, then you don't have to even think, you just see it and you laugh. You just see and you know it's wrong. It's all absurdity. We went to see one temple in India. And there were some pujaris here doing puja, uja. So the Indian sojourners ran out. I said, what happened? Mother, they are all hypocrites there. Horrible vibrations. How can they do puja? They have horrible vibrations, all boots. Bahut khana nikal jata hai. Abhi sukho usi hook mein upar atka do bas. Bol do ma. You are life and you see life. And the third thing that happens, that you humble down. You humble down. You become extremely sweet, obedient, just like children. And you don't mind anything you don't mind. That is the state. You achieve not as a slave, not out of domination, but it just works in you. It penetrates into your brain. You become that. I've seen people who are horrid, absolutely. And after some time you can't even recognize them. How do they change? How do they get the change? What happens to them? Is the brain is enlightened, has become the light, and you know you have the light. That is his doubtless awareness. You should have no doubts about yourself that you are a sojourner. But some people falsely have. They are Bhoots Patel, say, no, we are Sajivis. That's not the thing. The discretion power becomes so beautiful of the Hamsa chakra. Because they are all connected, Vishuddhi, Hamsa and Virat. They are all connected centers. It's not only that the Virata improves, but Vishuddhi improves and Hamsa. So now what happens that you jump into collectivity? Collectivity is the blessing of Viratangana. She teaches you how to love each other. She teaches you how to enjoy other sadhus. She teaches you how to have bhakti in your heart. But that teaching is like innate. If I say she teaches, means you are the disciple and she is the teacher. No, no. You become Viratangana yourself. And the love and the affection and the understanding that you have for each other is remarkable. It's very enjoyable and very beautiful. So all that happens, absolutely happens in your brain. That's how your brain, which is the one which receives all the information and creates all the information, creates all the mental projections, becomes a new vehicle to create a dimension which goes higher, not declining. All of you are part and parcel of it. All of you are part and parcel of that. And all of you are important. All of you have to support that. All of you have to raise it. It is very important you all should understand your own responsibility. So, between South and North America, we have to at least have 16,000 sadhus. Krishna was very clever. He created his 16,000 powers into ladies. Then these 16,000 women were taken away by one king and he just kept them. So Sri Krishna went and defeated that king and brought all 16,000 powers to himself. Very nice. He could do all those tricks, not me. I have to have 16,000 children who are human beings and who get this power within them. Not like my own powers I manifest. What is the use? You can't give realizations to others. You cannot communicate with others. You cannot do anything with them. So Sri Krishna only told Gita, finished. They were clever people. They didn't want to face the problem. It's very difficult. You people have a bad Vishuddhi, I get it. You people have a problem, I get it. It's just collectively to work out, to take you inside my body as a cell and to cleanse it. It's very, very difficult task, but one has to do it. One has to do it and one will do it. I'm sure one day when you all will be completely aware of Viratangana power within yourself, I don't know what will happen to this country. As it is, I find it's just bubbling now, about to break. It's a big breakthrough I find this year. Among Sahajogis as well as among the other people. But there was another quality of Sri Krishna, was diplomacy. He is to be diplomatic. With others, you have to be diplomatic. You should not just jump on them and try to oppress them or in any way try to show that they are nowhere compared to you. No. You should say, we were like you, worse than you. Then people are happy. But see, now we have changed. Just say, somebody says that I was smuggling drugs, you should say, no, I was smuggling even arms. Then their ego will not be hurt. If their ego is not hurt, then it's easy. So diplomacy also you must learn. Also, diplomacy is a mental projection at a lower level. At a higher level, diplomacy is where is your charisma, where you attract people, where you capture them, how you talk to them, how you behave towards them, and also have a compassion, because you are not sitting on the Himalayas. But what about these poor people? In that way, if you see the whole thing, I am sure you will not feel so much that you are doing this work and that work. Sri Krishna's whole philosophy is like this, that you should get your jnana. Jnana is, jnana means gnostics. You have to become gnostics. Means on your central nervous you must know it. That's first thing. The second thing was, because Arjuna was so half-hearted, still he asked him questions. So he said, what about karma? Everybody talks of karma, they said. Again, diplomacy. The whole Gita is full of diplomacy, and normal human beings cannot understand. So he said, yes, of course, you must do your karmas, but you have to surrender your karmas at my lotus feet. No, not possible. Very clever. Because as long as you have, I am doing this, I am doing that idea, how can you put your karmas onto the feet of Sri Krishna? That means you should get your realization where you know that you are not doing anything. When that happens, that you know that you are not doing anything, at that time, the karma becomes a karma. And how you talk, I have seen people raising kundal. Mother, it doesn't rise, it doesn't work. They don't say that I am doing it. You just say, it doesn't rise, it doesn't work out, in the third person. Another is about bhakti, because now we have lots of these Hare Ramas and Hare Krishnas and Amrantam, spoiling their Vishuddhis. So for bhakti, he has used only one word. He says, you give me flowers, you give me water, you give me leaves, I'll take them. But while giving, what does he say? But you must do ananya bhakti. Ananya means when there is not the other, when you become one with me, when you are connected. On ananya word, he has danced the whole thing, and the stupid people don't know that they are not connected as yet, and they are talking about Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. That's how they are not connected. They don't understand that they have to be connected. And this is the trick he has played with all the people, that all right, you go on saying Hare Rama, Hare Rama, we'll see. So the diplomacy part, in his case, because he had to bring them to the point that No, this doesn't work out. No, this doesn't work out. So then jnana. Now what is jnana? Is they start reading book. No. It means both. Means on your central nervous system you have to. So how gradually he brought them to that level? In the same way, when you are dealing with others, you have to work it out that way. And once you work it out that way, you can spread Sahaja Yoga much faster. You will be a very liked person. Everybody will enjoy you, and you will have no temper, nothing. We get into temper because we don't know how to handle the situation. If you know how to handle the situation, we'll never get angry. On the contrary, use the anger of another person for your own benefit. All these things you learn through the power of Viratanga. Viratangana gives you the full detachment from every subject of worry. She sucks in all these and throws them in the air. It is her great power that has really given you such an understanding about life, about yourself. Your own value system has changed. If you see what a change it was for you, all this transformation, everything is the power of Viratangana. And ultimately what she gives you is Niranand, is the joy, joy and nothing else but joy. May God bless you. I must give full credit here to Gregor because he came and struggled and fought. And like Arjuna, you see, he felt very desperate and went up. He had to go also in any way. And suddenly as he is gone, I find here it's everything so sprouting so well. And people have started taking over the responsibility of working out Sajjana. But I still remember him at this time because he was really very desperate and absolutely fed up with the American style of thinking. But now we'll give him a very good news that how America has improved. We have many surgeons in America who have been very dedicated despite all kinds of negative forces and everything. With all the nightmares they have gone through, they have stuck on to Sajoga, and I find that their efforts are now showing results. I will not take their names because you know all of them very well, one by one. But I must say that Stephen has done a great contribution. I never asked him to come to America, but he himself decided. And himself came here on his own, and he has really contributed a lot to Sahaja Yoga by coming here. May God bless you. Of course, your leader is there, and all the leaders in every place have been really working very hard. And I just see how things have prospered in 1 year's time. It's very creditable. We never had so many people for the puja. So I'm quite surprised at all of you being here. Thank you very much.